Christ Life Ministries International brings to you a program, Hearing Jesus, with Prophet Xavier Kale Alpha.
Position yourself in the dimension that will guarantee you nothing less but the life of God. That dimension is the voice of His Son.
Cultivating the true pattern of Christianity through sound doctrine for fellowship with the Spirit and proficient ministry among our hearers.
Yeah. Now, wisdom is here for me now to be able to follow after. I have been given a yardstick.
Yes.
Let me listen to a conversation that comes out of Apostle Tom.
Uh-huh.
If it is of the Word of God, then my identity and my being now is meant to submit to that.
Yes.
Because that Word of God,
yes,
now carries me into now the transformation that we see in the church in Thessalonians.
Yes, yes.
That this man keeps on committing them unto the Word of God.
Praise God.
Unto the Word of His power.
Praise God.
That is able to lift them up,
yes,
and give them an inheritance amongst the saints.
Yes.
Meaning that when I commit you to this Word, I am not drawing you to me. I am drawing you to that
praise
is divine.
The Lord.
The inheritance.
Yes.
That is what my man of God, I also believe that it is also void for you to claim for inheritance before you understand that buffers that the same.
Yes.
You see, we would want to see the miracles. We want to see the results therein. We,
yes,
would want to call ourselves the child of God.
Yes.
We would want to tell ourselves that, you know, we have overcome the world. But what gives you the legal mandate for you to walk in the same?
Praise
this
God.
Is what Paul is saying.
Praise God.
He's, the writer of Hebrew is saying, he's saying that, you see, there are men that I have put as a gift,
yeah,
amongst you.
Yeah.
But this is how you should know what to follow.
Yeah.
Yes, they have a part to play, as the Bible has said that these particular teachers have a mandate that I've put upon their life.
Yes.
To be accountable for what I've done for them.
Yes.
But for you, the hearer, also, you should know who is right and who is wrong. Them that have spoken the Word of God over you.
Yes.
Those are worthy of following.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise
that is why now it establishes the fact that when you hear the Word,
yes,
you are hearing Jesus.
You're hearing Jesus.
And that establishes you to be worthy as a follower. To,
yeah,
for even for you to call yourself a follower,
yes,
there has to be a jurisdiction. There has to be a hearing of the Word. And that Word is what establishes a faith for me to follow. You see, if you're very keen, you'll realize that after he mentions the Word of God, now he says, whose faith follow? Because faith comes
by hearing. And hearing
so,
about Jesus.
Yes, so that has come on them,
yeah,
is worthy of following because it has a good source for them.
Praise God.
Truth to be told, there is also human kind of faith.
Yes.
They are they that carry a faith that does not come by hearing the Word of,
yes,
God. So what qualifies this kind of faith?
Uh-huh.
There has to be a word behind it.
Yes.
That a man cannot just stand to claim, I have faith in God.
Yes.
They have to have proved to have a flow of the Word coming not only to them,
praise
but
God,
also out of
praise
them.
The Lord.
Because faith comes and faith also is ministered.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
So the hearing of the Word is the hearing of Jesus.
Yes.
And that hearing brings to you the author and the finisher of the faith.
Oh, praise
now
God.
You are worthy of following.
Praise God. Praise
now I
God.
Understand,
yeah,
why men,
yeah,
will desire by conscience,
yes,
to follow me.
Yeah.
Because I have given myself heed to,
exactly,
the Word.
Yeah. That's powerful.
Glory to God.
That is powerful.
Glory to God.
Yes,
that, wow, that is so powerful.
Mm.
You have emphasized something that has caught my attention.
Mm.
The place of the emphasis,
yeah,
of the function of faith.
Mm-hmm.
Because when Paul talks about the end of their faith there,
yes,
and talks about, like you said, the formage of the character,
yeah,
of the person of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Because again, if you study the life of Paul, by the time he says to the church of Corinth again, was it Corinth?
Yeah.
Is it where he says, imitate me,
yes,
as I imitate,
yes,
Christ?
Mm.
You get a picture.
Corinth. Mm.
He says, 1 Corinthians 11, verses 1, he says, imitate me just as I also imitate Christ.
Yeah.
Now, if you look at that church again, that church of Corinth had every spiritual gift.
Yes, sir, I hear you.
They had every spiritual gift.
Yes.
When you study the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 1, from verses 4,
yes,
he will tell you in the NLT Bible, he says, yes, I thank my God.
Yes.
Look at it this way.
Mm.
NLT Bible. Mm. He says, I always thank my God
for you
and for the gracious gifts he has given you.
Yes.
He says, now that you belong to who?
Jesus.
Look at verses 5. He says, through him, God has enriched your church.
Through Jesus.
Who?
Yes.
Through Jesus.
Yes. Very key.
Yes.
Very key.
In every way,
yeah,
with all of your eloquent words,
mm,
and all of your knowledge.
So they had the eloquent words.
Eloquent words.
My
through
God.
Jesus.
Through Jesus. Jesus. Yeah.
You get a picture.
Mm.
Look at verses 6.
Mm.
This confirms that what I told you about Christ
is true.
So, why are they eloquent? Why do they have the gracious
gift? Because he told them
about
Christ. Meaning,
yes,
he preached Christ to them.
Yes, sir.
Until they were carried into gifts. Into spiritual eloquence.
Yes.
Apostle, that's powerful.
How do you explain him who wants to just lay hands on you for you to receive?
For the laying on of hands for them to receive a gift.
Now, that's where I'm going.
Yeah.
Come on.
Now, look at the verses 7.
Yes.
Look at verses 7.
Yes.
He says, now, look at that. I want you to read.
Yeah.
He says, you have every spiritual gift you need, as you eagerly wait for the return of
our Lord Jesus Christ.
That means this church was equipped, mm, as far as the spiritual gifts were concerned.
Yes.
But when you go to chapter 3,
yeah,
it is still the same church.
Yes,
because I want,
yes,
us to open to our hearers the progression.
Yeah.
The progression.
Yes.
Now look at chapter 3. This is the same church, still,
yes,
in the NLT.
Mm.
He says, and dear brothers and sisters, mm, when I was with you,
yes,
I couldn't talk to you,
mm,
as I would to spiritual people.
Mm.
The same church.
The same church.
Uh-huh.
Few minutes ago, he said they had spiritual gifts.
And they were eagerly awaiting.
That means,
for the return of Jesus.
The fact that they had spiritual gifts,
uh-huh,
did not qualify them enough to be spiritual people. It will be so hard for someone to comprehend
that. Is so
that
deep.
Very,
but I want to break it down.
Yes.
For example, they had the gifts of speaking in tongues. How do I know? When you go onwards, you hear the narrative of how the church spoke in tongues until speaking in tongues became a competition. How that the church prophesied,
yes,
until prophecy became a competition.
But you know, we're seeing that in our day.
Yes.
Absolutely.
There's one who wants to prove he can pray more than the other. There's one who wants to prove that he's a deeper prophet than the other.
Which is absolutely no sign of spirituality.
Of spirituality.
According to what you're saying.
Yes. Because, right?
But they are claiming,
they are claiming
that it's a level spirituality.
In spirituality.
Yes, sir.
So Paul is saying, I couldn't talk to you as I would to spiritual people.
Hi.
Wait.
And yet you are enriched.
Enriched with all gracious gifts. Every spiritual.
Yeah. All eloquence.
Yes. Knowledge.
All knowledge.
Now, I want I want us to follow this. He says, look at this. I had to talk to you as though you belong to this world. He says, oh, as though you were infants in the Christian life. Look at verses 2. He says, I had to feed you with milk, not with solid food. Aye.
Uh-huh.
Now, I want to first pause there a little.
Yes.
Let's go to Hebrews chapter 5.
Yes, sir.
Hebrews chapter 5 from verses 11.
Oh, glory to God.
The Bible says, this is Paul again talking about this narrative. He says, there is much more
we would like to say about this.
Remember when he began verses 1, he was talking about
Melchizedek,
the Messiah, or Jesus, the righteous one.
Yes.
So he was talking about the priesthood of Jesus. You get a picture?
He was literally talking about Jesus.
Yes, the message about Jesus. So he's telling these people again that I want to talk to you deeper things about this man. But he says, there is more I would like to say about this, but it is difficult to explain.
Yes.
Especially since you are spiritually dull and don't seem to listen.
Ha! 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 Okay.
Look at verses 12.
Okay.
He says, you have been believers so long.
Hi!
Now that you ought to be teaching others.
Okay.
The length, the longevity of being a Christian.
Is not a certification.
It's not a certification
that you are a pattern.
That you are spiritual. Let me say it that way.
That you have become a stronghold,
a ruler.
You get what I'm saying? He says, instead, now look at this. You need someone to teach you again the basic things about God's word.
And what are those basics? Then Hebrews chapter 6, verse 1. Let's first continue.
He says, you are like babies
who need milk?
Who need milk?
And cannot eat solid food.
So the same church here is the same church in 1 Corinthians chapter 3.
And the highlight of their problem is they don't want to listen.
They don't want to listen.
Yes, sir.
And Paul tells you in verse 13 what they were unskilled in.
Yeah.
He says, look at this. For someone who lives on milk is still an infant and doesn't know
how to do what is right.
If we could have it in the
KJV.
In the King James. Look at it in the King James.
Yes.
He says, for everyone that uses milk is unskillful in what?
In the word of righteousness.
For he is a babe. The word of righteousness is the message.
It's the gospel.
It's a message
about it says, I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God. And then he says, for therein is the righteousness of God
revealed from faith
to faith. And
so
this is what
he's saying. About the gospel.
Yes.
The gospel about Jesus.
Yes.
So I wanted to bring that out before we go back to 1 Corinthians.
Yes, sir.
Because we want us to study that church.
Yeah.
Now, if you go back to 1 Corinthians chapter 3, still in the NLT, he's progressing.
Yeah.
He says, I had to feed you with milk and not with solid food because you weren't ready for anything stronger. That means they were not skilled in the word of righteousness. He says, and you are still aren't ready. He says, for you are still controlled by your sinful nature. They are so gifted, but they are still controlled by their sinful nature. They can prophesy, but they are still controlled by their sinful nature.
Yes.
They can speak in tongues. The thing we talked about a few weeks ago about Peter.
Yes.
The flesh and blood.
In other words, the power to deny the sinful nature.
Yes.
A place to control.
Control.
Is not even in prayer.
No.
It is when you choose to listen.
To listen.
To the word of God.
The word of God. They were that kind of people. Who were so noisy about gifts and they didn't appreciate the place of the word.
I wish I can share a testimony.
Yes.
When I was growing up in the Christian circle,
yeah,
I was still dealing with alcohol.
Yes.
And drugs.
Yes.
Men told me, go and pray. Go to the prayer mountain. I did 21 days at the prayer mountain. But the same day I came down from the prayer mountain, I went back to.
You were thirsty for alcohol.
I'm sorry, I had to laugh at it.
I'm telling you, let me tell you, you see, some of these things may seem to be far-fetched, but it's a truth. That place of prayer may never break this power of blood and flesh.
Yeah.
Until I came in contact with the word.
With the word.
The message.
The habit goes. And you see, this is present with us, even in church.
Yeah.
It is possible for you to think that the place of prayer is what is going to bring you into line. And you keep failing and you think that God is actually not at work in you. Yet he desires you to come to a place of communion.
Yeah.
I felt like I needed to share.
That is so powerful. I love the fact that we relate with this.
Yes.
Because again, that experience explains one that is gifted.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yes.
You could pray by the time they send you to pray.
Yeah.
But the thing about these gifts is not that God ain't in them.
Uh-huh.
The thing about these gifts is that they are supposed to be founded on the doctrine of righteousness, the message about Jesus. You see, the functionality of gifts is supposed to ride on the teaching of the word. The message is the empowerment to the function of gifts. Gifts, you know, if gifts are not founded on the teaching of the word, the message, they don't have the power to build. Because the character that builds men is not the gift.
Yeah.
The character that builds is the word operating in the gift.
Yeah.
You see the picture? It's the thing about Paul that encounters Jesus,
yeah,
and he cannot establish men yet. And God has to take Paul through years of training,
yes,
through years of teaching,
yes,
through years of growth,
yes,
so that when he is established in this word, he can train other men to stand in the very thing he has been established. So that's the progression. He says, you are jealousy of one another and quarrel with each other.
Yeah.
Doesn't that prove you are controlled by your sinful nature? Aren't you living like people of this world?
Yeah.
They were so gifted, but they were living like people of this world. So terrible. But I want us to progress. Look at verses 4.
Yeah.
He says, when one of you says, I am a follower of Paul.
We see that happen today.
Yeah. Absolutely. And then the other is saying, I'm a follower of Apollos.
Whoa, what is the difference between that one and Peter who says, let's build tabernacles?
There is no difference. There is no difference. Because
no difference.
When you say, let us build one tabernacle for Moses and one for Elijah, when you choose Apollos, you have chosen a tabernacle to which you belong.
Yeah.
And the one who says, I have chosen Paul, has also chosen a tabernacle to which
they fall. And that's where the differences are coming from.
Yeah.
So for Jesus, for God to tell them, here Jesus, he was trying to say, if you're going to grow above tabernacles, there's only one place, the place of the message.
My God.
Oh, yes.
That's why the unification of the church is not going to come by tabernacles. It's going to come by the message.
Say that again.
The unification of the church is not going to come by tabernacles. It's going to come by the message.
In other words, when we incline to the message,
yes,
when we gravitate towards the message, unity will be default.
Absolutely.
It's paramount. Because again, the unity of the faith means the message brought the faith.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you can't anticipate a faith or unity of a faith that you don't have a message of.
When the message is
the grounding of the faith.
You cannot anticipate the unity of a faith whose message you do not have. Wow.
So he continues and says, I follow Apollos. Aren't you acting just like the world people? Look at verses 5. He says, after all, who is Apollos?
And who is Paul?
Who is Paul? We are all God's servants.
Through whom
you believed
the good news.
The message.
So I'm a channel through which.
Yeah. Yeah.
He says,
Each of us did the work
the Lord gave us. Look at verses 6. Now, I want you to see this.
Yes.
I planted the seed in your heart.
Yes.
This is Paul speaking. How did he plant the seed? It is as though Paul is reminding this man.
Yes.
Luke 8:11. Mm-hmm. The parable is
the seed.
The seed is
the
word
of God.
So what did Paul plant in this man was actually the message. So he planted in this man the message about Jesus.
Yes.
Then he says, and Apollos watered it.
Yes.
Now you're going to think he's talking about natural water.
Yeah.
The watering there again was also about the word.
About the word, yes.
This is a revelation of the distinctions in the function of what Apollos has to offer as a minister. You get a picture?
Yes.
The stage with which he comes in. Remember, this Apollos, before the Bible says, before he met Aquila and Priscilla, he was preaching the gospel of John the Baptist.
But he did not know the way of the Lord perfectly.
But the Bible says later that he profited the church of Corinth.
Yes. After the way of the Lord was made more perfect to him. But to even think that the way of the Lord is a revelation. In the word. But that the way of the Lord is actually the message of Jesus.
The message of Jesus.
It's humbling.
And he says, but it was God who made it grow.
Yeah.
Now, it tells you that growth comes by a planting.
And a watering.
And a watering. That means for God to grow you, for God to increase you, he bases on the seed of the word and the watering of the word.
So if you don't have the seeding of the word and the watering of the word, there will be no need for God to grow you.
And that was the problem with the church of Corinth.
That explains why certain marriages are stagnated, why businesses are stagnated, why people's,
it's not growing.
Someone stays sick for decades. That's it.
Do you know, I can tell you, your marriage is going to be great. And I'm lying.
Yes.
And I'm lying to you. Because on the foundation of what?
You know the New Year meetings?
Yes.
That happen?
Yes.
Next, this year, you are being given double for your trouble. You are calling for a principle whose convenience for fulfillment is also on the account of a particular principle. Now, on what grounds do I promise you an increase whose principle you are not found in?
Unless you are a kind that is crafty.
Uh-huh. Or you are a witch.
Or you witch.
Yes.
You want to make things happen.
So we are having witches that are declaring into our ears.
Yes.
And we have chosen to believe that.
No, I mean, Paul the Apostle says, there are things I want to tell you. He says it to the church in the book of Hebrews. He says it again in Corinthians. There are things I can, just like Jesus. You remember where Jesus says there is many things I want to tell you, but you are not able. We see the same discipline in Paul. You see?
Yeah.
Where now do you get the right to communicate things Paul and Jesus feared to communicate? Because they found that the principle by which those things operate and exist was wanting in men. So by time for you, you can pull a line and create the possibility for the operation of those things.
You even make a poster.
You even make a poster. It only means you are God above God.
Even God, let me say this, even God had to trust Paul first to teach and Apollos to water for him to give the increase.
You will need to repeat you, that.
Please say that again.
Even God has to firstly trust
Paul
to teach
and Apollos to water. Again by teaching
for him
before he could give the increase.
So I will be a fool expecting a growth within that God was also trusting to wait that it may happen for him to cause the growth.
Man of God, this is what I've also heard.
Yes, sir.
That increase by God is a function of teaching and teaching. Or hearing and hearing.
My God. Faith to faith.
Faith to faith.
It explains the frustrated Christian lives.
Yes.
The frustrated prayer lives.
Yes.
The frustrated giving life.
Yes.
The frustrated financial lives.
Yes.
Because why do you expect a growth you are not seated in?
Thank you for tuning in. That was Hearing Jesus with Prophet Xavier Kale Alpha. To partner with us or for any other information, reach us through the details available on the screen. Christ Life Ministries International. Christ to influence.